Hi, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to SA Accounting Academy. Here's a short clip on one of our previous webinars. I hope that you really do enjoy it.
So I've got 2 hours of your time this morning to chat about all sorts of interesting things, trying to keep our spirits up. Can you believe that today is the 30th of June? I'm trying to get my head around the fact that we are halfway through 2021. I keep on feeling like the year's just started and it's sort of stop, started. Here we go, they're back again. So it does feel weird. I know there are many of you that might be dealing with financial year-ends today. I know that the municipalities, for example, have got their financial year-ends, and quite a few big companies have got financial year-end today. Once July's done and we start the long months, the year just seems to rush by. I know that schools are supposed to be closing today for the third wave for adjusted level 4. So I hope those of you that have got children coming home into the nest, everybody is well and we're all going to just adapt. Thank goodness, as South Africans, we are very adaptable and we are very good at change management. We are most probably the masters of change management. Yeah, welcome. Without further ado, we've got quite a bit to cover. Let's get into it. It's good to see you all this morning, and I hope that the weather is good wherever you are and that you are wonderful. Okay. About the ethics in August, there's a good chance that I am doing it because I've done it before and I know that it sounds familiar. I think, Greta, I am doing the site ethics. Ethics is kind of my thing. And if I'm not mistaken, I think we booked that like in February. So it will be me. So I look forward to having a chat with you then as well. So please ask questions. I will try and handle them as best I can. It's quite technical and there's all sorts of information, things that I've had to get up to date with and literally was researching and reading up until yesterday. So hot off the press kind of idea. So please have pop your questions in. We'll do the best we can. And we'll have fun. Roy, are you saying that you're hot in the Midlands? I'm in KZN. I'm pretty cool here in the Midlands, so I'm hoping it warms up where I'm sitting. Okay. I'm loving the engagement. I really do. I thrive on the engagement. I thrive on the questions. It's always great with this audience. This audience is amazing because I don't feel like I'm locked in a box. I said to somebody the other day, if anybody had to spy on me while I had my work day, they'd think all I do is talk to a computer screen. So it's really enjoyable to see that I actually have some connection with some people out there. So that's me. We've got our usual course outline for these. We kind of keep the structure. It gives us something to practice with and to work from. Okay. The practice note, I'm not going to cover that in my session today. I'm not a tax expert, and that's something that Letty handles tax maybe a bit more deeply than I do. I can get insight into that. My challenge is that, I always say that I focus on everything but tax. I had to give something up in my life. There's just too much to focus on and too much work to do. And so tax is what I sacrificed in my wanderings. But I do have the tax newsletters that come through from my tax associate that works with me. I have pulled a few ideas through from there, and if you are wanting more information and all the rest on that, I can direct you to useful resources. Okay. So we're going to go through a lot of the different issues and a lot of the different work. I try and make these sessions a bit broader than just, Companies Act and all the rest, because I do think as a monthly legislation and compliance update, it's also an interesting space just to lift our heads and find out what's happening around in law. Okay. My curiosity, this is my opportunity also just to go squirreling around and see what the other regulators and what other people are doing, which may have an impact in our lives. I think it's also just good to have good general knowledge about the laws and see what is up and what is going on. Okay. I will keep my video on. I've taken it as a personal challenge, dare I say, to keep my video on as much as possible. Only if I have an internet issue will I switch it off. But I do think it's better for us to see each other. Okay. I had selected this quote for today's session a while back. I just think, you know, maybe, you know, Greta, with ethics being so much part of what I've been doing lately, this quote came up in my ramblings and my wanderings, and I really did, you know, it really struck me as something that we need to take on and something to we need to work with. I'm sitting listening to my son talking about a little boy in his class who's like coming first, but through not the most honest means. He's known to be cheating and known to be doing this and doing that, and how absolutely disgusted and how you know, affronted these little boys are that somebody who is behaving this way, and it's in such an obvious way, is being rewarded for it in the system. So I sat down and I've had these conversations with him, and this quote came up: rather fail with honor than succeed by fraud. And it really just struck me that is really the attitude we need to have, is that do something honestly and sleep well, even if you don't get where you think you should get or get where you hope to get, then succeed by false means. And it was quite ironic because yesterday's news about the contempt of court, I love South Africa because the announcement wasn't even made, and the memes that go flying around. So I think it is something, the message that needs to really get out there is that we need to have a respect for each other. We need to honor hard work and rather fall short and be proud of the effort that we made than try and get there in other ways. Okay. So I just want to lay that down as a seed for thought, and in your life and what you're doing. I would rather be unsuccessful but know that I gave it an honest, good shot than be successful in a way that's not the best. And I think we've got to look at these perspectives and look at these attitudes and ask ourselves why we do what we do. So with that in mind, getting to the work that we have to do today, there is quite a bit to get through. Although I never know with these sessions, sometimes we go through quite quickly and sometimes we take it a bit slower. With the accounting update, there have been meetings. I don't know how many of you were on my IFRS SME session. I actually went through the minutes of the International Accounting Standards Board quite in detail, because of course you know that we are aligning with full IFRS, and the International Accounting Standards Board have gone through sort of the critical standards that they want to align with. Obviously the key ones being all things consolidation, business combination, fair value. And fair value is a critical one that they're aligning with because of, well, financial instruments that they want to align with, and revenue and leasing. Okay, so there hasn't been anything new on the IFRS SMEs front other than that. They've obviously gone off now and they are busy drafting and writing up the exposure draft. So that's really the next step that we're expecting in the IFRS for SME land. What it does mean, and I keep on bringing this to everybody's attention, is that we need to be very careful now about advising our clients that are moving from IFRS to IFRS for SMEs, or IFRS for SMEs to bigger IFRS. Well, IFRS for SMEs up to bigger IFRS, I'm not worried about. I'm more worried about the step down of clients that are on IFRS and wanting to step down to IFRS for SMEs, because often the reason that they are making that step is the financial instrument step. And now, until we see the exposure draft, we actually don't know how much of a relief they're going to have in IFRS for SMEs compared to what they're doing in full IFRS. So it will, you know, you'll look like you've got egg on your face if you advise your client to step down because they're wanting to have the simplified approach and hoping that the financial instruments won't be what it's been for such a long time, and then only to have the new IFRS for SME standard be very similar to what the current IFRS issue is.
I hope that you enjoyed that video. For more of our webinar videos, go to www.accountingacademy.co.za. Thank you and have a lovely day.